Welcome to the class. In the series of Partnership Act 1932, let's discuss today about kinds of partners. In the earlier video, we have already discussed about the definition and essential features of partnership. So in this video, we are only going to talk about various kinds of partners under Partnership Act 1932. Let's see. Yes, the first one and the most popular one is active partner. You all might have heard about active partner. As the name indicates, he is the one who runs the business. We all know by now that partnership can be formed only for doing business, and therefore active partner is the one who on behalf of other partners conducts the business. Okay, and therefore active partner is known to the outside world. How does it happen? Because he is the one who deals with customers, he is the one who deals with suppliers, he is the one who is seen by the outside world. And therefore, whenever an active partner retires, he must give a public notice. Okay, now let's see. Yes. There is a sleeping partner as well. Sleeping partner is also known as dormant partner. That means this kind of partners do not play an active role in the business. They may not be regular in the office. They may not take decisions for the firm. Rather, they are not at all active as far as the business of the firm is concerned. But at the same time, they might be bringing in investment, they will be sharing the losses, they will be sharing the profit, but the outside world is not seeing them and the outside world never recognized them. And therefore, unlike an active partner, when a sleeping or dormant partner retires, he or she need not give a public notice. Okay, now let's see. As a sub-agent, a sub-partner is the one who has partnership with one among the partners. But sub-partner has nothing to do with the partnership firm. A sub-partner cannot make the partnership firm or the partners liable for his actions. Similarly, the actions of the partnership firm or the partners will not make the sub-partner liable. Okay, now nominal partner. Nominal partner, as the name indicates, is the one who lends his name to the firm. He may not take an active role in conducting the business, but his name is more than enough. His name is the investment which he is making. Normally, people who are celebrities, who are popular in the field, allow others to conduct the business using their name or their goodwill as an investment. And a nominal partner, like an active partner, is known to the outside world. And therefore, whenever he retires, he must give a public notice. Nominal partner, like an active partner, will be sharing the losses and the profit. That all depends on the partnership deed. Okay, now, partner by holding out. See what happens when an active partner or a nominal partner retires, and if they don't give, and if what happens when an active partner or a nominal partner retires and they are not giving a public notice? What will happen? The public will continue to believe that they are still there with the partnership firm, and the public will continue to give credit. The public will continue to deal with the partnership firm as if these people are there in the firm. What happens when an active partner or a nominal partner retires and still doesn't give a public notice? The public will continue to believe that these people are part of the firm, and that might result in giving credit or dealing with the firm as if they are the partners. And later they realize that these people are not there, their liability is not going to go. Because since they did not give a public notice, they will continue to be liable as if they are the partners, because the public believes them to be the partners. You got the idea? So even though they have retired, they are holding on to their earlier position as if they are the partners. They will continue to be liable. So it is ideal for a nominal partner and an active partner to give a public notice as soon as they go out of the firm. Otherwise, they will be partners by holding out. Okay, now the last one. We are aware of the concept of estoppel. Estoppel says that you are causing another person to believe at the existence of something, whatever it may be. So in case of partnership, what happens? A, suppose he is not a partner in a firm, but he allows B to believe that he is a partner in a firm. This can be either by A directly telling B that I am a partner, or allowing C to tell B that he is a partner. So knowingly, he is allowing or he is causing another person to believe that he is a partner. Actually, he is not a partner. So when there is a liability happening, that time he cannot deny. You got the point? Initially, he has shown off as he is a partner, and later when it comes to liability, he cannot waive off the liability. If he has allowed people to believe that he is a partner, he must incur the liability as well. Is that clear? So these are the various kinds of partners according to Partnership Act 1932. I hope it's clear to you. If you have still suggestions, comments, needs clarification, please make use of my comment box. I'll be happy to help.